So how much is a human life worth? I mean, how much is your life worth? How much is the life of somebody you love worth? If you were to add up all of the time and the energy you invest in somebody's life, how much would it actually cost? For the hero in this story, it's exactly 50 grams of gold. Not 1 gram less, or the woman he loves will die. This is the story of a man who sacrificed everything for love. Not just for one person, but for hundreds of people. And in the process, he became a hero. So stick with me through this 5-episode series called The Price of Life, because I guarantee you, it's going to change the way you see the world forever. So who is the hero in this story? Here he is. His name's Józef Walaszczyk. He's quite a handsome guy, I think you'll agree. So what kind of person is Joseph? Well, when he's at school, he's getting bullied, so he escapes with a friend. They get caught, sent back, and he gets expelled. At another school, his friend Henry's getting beaten by the teachers for no reason whatsoever, so Joseph organises a school-wide rebellion. He gets kicked out of that school too. At military camp in June 1939, some Jewish friends of his are getting bullied by the other cadets. So he doesn't stand by and watch it. He organises a gang that goes and beats up the bullies. So Joseph is somebody who believes in honour and dignity. And this is where the story begins. And here he is, my friends. This is Joseph. He's still alive. In fact, he's 100 this year. He's as sharp as a tack, and I got the privilege of spending an hour with him at the Poland Museum of the History of Polish Jews in Warsaw, Poland. I've got to warn you, ladies, he's quite the charmer. 1st of September 1939, Poland is invaded by Germany. They attack from the air and Blitzkrieg rolls over Poland in a brutal bloody fight. This is the first time that genocidal war has been waged at such a level. Joseph tries to join his unit. He's attacked again and again from the air by Stuka dive bombers. And you remember Stuka dive bombers? You know that sound effect that they use in films? That's not a sound effect. That's actually what they were like. So you can imagine what the terror was like. He manages to escape from German captivity and goes back to his family farm and his factory. Joseph's at a party in spring 1941 when he meets a beautiful woman called Irena.
Była bardzo ładna, zgrabna, podobała mi się, więc nawiązałem z nią kontakt. Jak przyjeżdżałem do Warszawy, to żeby się spotykali.
So, like young people do when they're in love with each other, they start to meet up regularly. Now, this is the Second World War, and Poland's been occupied by the Nazi Germans, so there's not some sort of hotel they can go to, but they meet up in the World War equivalent of an Airbnb. And it's one day when they're in an Airbnb when they hear a furious knocking at the entrance to the building, the kind of knocking that only means one thing. The Gestapo are coming.
Walenie. Walenie i hargot niemiecki, Gestapo przyjechało sprawdzać przyjezdnych.
So here's the sting in the tale, because Irena has been keeping a secret from Joseph, her boyfriend.
Mówi, słuchaj, ja jestem Żydówką, nie mam żadnych dokumentów. Ja nie jestem, podawała się, że nazywa się Barczak. Mówi, ja nie jestem Barczak, ja jestem front, dokumentów żadnych nie mam.
That's right. The Gestapo knocking at the door. Joseph has just found out that the woman he loves has been hiding a secret from him. And that secret, well, at the very least, if they're lucky, when the Gestapo come in, they'll both be sent to a concentration camp. But more likely, they'd be arrested, interrogated, tortured, or shot on the spot. And he's got seconds to make a decision.
Bałam się, że się wiadomość skończy. Znaczy, tam było szereg pokoi.
Tak.
Szereg pokoi. I ja miałam pokój ostatni, taki w korytarzu, ostatni pokój.
So how do you get out of a situation like that? I mean, I'm getting kind of sweaty just even thinking about it. She's got no papers. The Gestapo are going to be in seconds. Well, Joseph's not making a YouTube video. He's the one who has to make a decision right now. If he doesn't, he will die.
Popatrzyłem po pokoju, zobaczyłem, że szafa stoi tak brzegiem, tak na róg. Wcisnąłem ją za tą szafę z rzeczami. Szafę docisnąłem do ściany, wziąłem dokumenty do ręki I wszedłem na korytarz, zamknąłem pokój na klucz.
So he's hidden Irena away, but he still needs to find a way to get the Gestapo out of his room, because by now they're in the corridor.
Doszedłem do niego, powiedziałem, że jestem bardzo chory I trzymałem zgięcie, podałem mu dokumenty, a miałem już dokumenty, już akceptowane jako kierownik fabryki.
Ah, the old sick stomach line. Well, I've pulled that one a few times at work myself. The Gestapo officer allows Joseph to go to the toilets, but meanwhile, he's still in the corridor and he still wants to get into that room.
jak sprawdził pokoje, doszedł do pokoju mojego i krzyczy do tej dyrektor, dlaczego tutaj ten pokój jest zamknięty?
Somehow the terrified woman, who knew Irena was behind that door, persuades the Gestapo officer that it's just Joseph, and the guy leaves.
Jak, co pan mówił do niej potem? Czy pan był zły na nią?
To już potem nie. Początkowo to byłem bardzo zły.
So Joseph goes to go and get her official papers, and of course he has to pay a hefty bribe to do so. But when he goes to pick up the papers, there's a twist in the tale. For this to work, Joseph and Irena have to be legally married.
No więc ja mówię, dlaczego? Przecież to konieczne jest, mój tak konieczne, bo jak twoja żona, to będziesz jej pilnował i my będziemy bezpieczni, ty będziesz bezpieczni.
So that line that Joseph just said there, that's actually really, really important, because everybody involved in getting these papers, which were illegal, sorted, would have seen this. And this thing says that anybody who helps a Jewish person in any way, hide or literally anything, will be executed without a trial, with no mercy given whatsoever. And this is the fact of the Second World War. In order to help just one person, you had to risk not only your own life, but that of your families, anyone you loved, and also the lives of anyone who needed to help you, and there would be plenty of people who would have to help you. You didn't get this kind of punishment in Western Europe, I'm not saying you wouldn't get in trouble, but literally the extent of the risk that you'd have to bring so many people in just to help one person was enormous. And everyone living around Joseph would have seen this poster. It promises that anyone who gives a Jewish person away, reveals where they're hiding, will get a reward of food. Now it's easy to condemn those people, it's easy for us to condemn them, and we should do that. But have you ever really been starving? And I don't mean starving as in you missed a meal or you're a little bit hungry. I mean weeks after weeks and months after months of not getting enough calories to live. Because those are the conditions in which people lived there. So whilst it's easy to condemn them, we should also understand those people as well. It makes the bravery of those people who did the right thing, despite all the temptation and the starvation, even more astounding. And if you got caught, stay tuned for episode 2 and this moment.
Wrzuciło go, wyciągnął pistolet i mówi, nie wolno przekupywać niemieckiego urzędnika.
Watch all 5 episodes of the Price of Life series and please share them with your friends and family.